Balehang
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 18, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 6th of November, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Translation. One who cannot deliver his dependents from the path of repeated birth and death should never become a spiritual master, a father, a husband, a mother, or a worshipable demigod.
Guru nasasyad sajano nasasyad, pita nasasyad janani nasasyad, daivam na tasyad patishta nasasyad. Namo jayega samupeta mittam. So, in the previous verse, it has been described that kastam sayam tat abhigya vipasti. The guardian should be abhigya and vipasti, very learned. The government, the father, the guru, the teacher, or even husband, or because we are guided, everyone is guided by somebody else. That is society, not cats and dogs. Just like the cats and dogs, they give birth to the children, and then they have no responsibility. The dogs are loitering in the street. Nobody takes care. The human society should not be like that. There must be responsible guardians. There are some of the responsible guardians are described here. First of all, guru. Either you take ordinary teacher in the school or colleges, they are also called guru. And the sublime guru is the spiritual master. Not only the spiritual master, but anyone who has taken the post of becoming guru to teach others, he must be very learned, very responsible, vipasti, abhijna, abhijnata. It is the qualification of the Supreme Personality of God, as it is said in the beginning of the Srimad Bhagavatam, abhijna. Janmadrasyajataha hanyat itaratascha arthesu avigyam. The controller must be avigyam. The same thing is here. Of course, we cannot be as avigyam as God. That is not possible. But a little quantity of that avigyata must be there. Otherwise, what is the use of becoming? First of all, it is said about guru. Anyone who takes care of his subordinate is guru. The first charge is that you should not become a guru unless you are completely in awareness how to save your dependent from the path of birth and death. That is the first place. Not that I am your guru, I can cure some colic pain in your belly. They go to Guru also for that purpose. People generally go to Guru, rascals go to Guru to another rascal. What is that? Sir, I have got some friend. Give me some ashirvad so that my pain may be cured. But why you come here, rascal, here for curing your pain in the village? You can go to some doctor or you can take some tablet. Is it the purpose of coming to Guru? But generally, they come to Guru and ask for blessing for some material benefit. So they are rascals, and therefore Krishna also gives them a rascal Guru. They want to be cheated. They do not know what is the purpose of going to Guru. They do not know. They do not know what is the problem of my life and why shall I go to Guru. They do not know. And the so-called gurus also take advantage of this ignorance of the public and they become a guru. This is going on. The guru does not know what is his responsibility and the rascal public, they do not know what for one should go to guru. This is the difficulty. Who requires a guru? Everything is there in the Shastra. Tasmād guruṁ prabhaddeta jignyāsu sreya uttamam. Tad vijñānātham sa gurumeva avigacche samitmāni sotijam brahmanistam. Tad viddhi panipātena paripasnena sevaya upadakshanti tad jñānam jñānina tattva darśinam. This is qualification of guru. Tattva darshi. What is that tattva? Madanti tattva vidastatyam jad jnanam adhyam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaniti sabda. One who knows what is paramatma, what is brahma, what is bhagavan, then he is tattva darshi. Vadanti tattva vidas tatyam jadvyanam adhyam. These are the qualifications of guru. Why one should go to a guru to see some magic? One who can make some gold, one who can make some, so many magicians, they are becoming guru. This is going on. The public, they do not know what is the meaning of guru, and the cheaters, they get the opportunity of becoming false gurus. In the Western countries, we have seen so many so-called rascal gurus go there and cheat the public because the Europeans, Americans, they have got some conviction that India has got some spiritual knowledge. So anyone goes as a sannyasi, as a sami, they expect to get something from them. So they gather around them. But these rascals cheat them. Somebody says, I am incarnation of God and I can make my secretary, woman, pregnant and marry and get some money. This is good. And somebody is transcendental meditation. What is the result of fun? And you will get strong, you will get money, your health will be well. These things are going on. But Shastra says that you should not, you are rascal, you should not become a guru because you have no power to save your disciple from the clutches of imminent death. You should not cheat others. Guru Nasasya. This is Bhagavad. You are rascal if you are not confident that you can save him from the clutches of birth. This is my problem. But they do not know what is the problem. They think the little pain in my belly or in the head If a guru can give me a little dust and it is cured, we'll find there are so many cheaters. About 40 years ago, I know near Lucknow, some guru camp, he was curing all disease by giving little dust. All cheating, later on it was detected. Thousands, thousands of men came to him, even big, big capitalists. Everyone has got some disease. They want to see the miracle by giving little dust and he is curing disease. Oh, such a guru. These things are going on. But Bhagavad says that both the public must know what for one should go to guru. So not that it is a fashion to keep a guru just like to keep a dog. No. He must know what is the purpose of guru. The purpose of guru is described in the Bhagavatam that the smart guru prabhadhis. Guru to go, to surrender. Just like Arjuna, he surrendered. Shishasriham sadhimam prapannam prapadde tasmad gurum prapadde. You must find out, guru, where you can surrender. Not that keep your guru, your order supply. Give me some asidbhad and I may be benefited. He is not guru, he is your order supply, your servant. Guru means he must order you. You must do this. If you agree, then he is a guru. Not that I shall order my guru and he will execute my order. No, that will do the dog, not the guru. As you have got a dog, and if you ask him, sit down here, a dog will sit down. That kind of guru keeping has no value. But here is the responsibility of guru, first, that he must save the disciple from the cycle of birth and death. Krishna also said, what is the problem of life? Not that I've got some pain here, I've some trouble or some. These are not problems. These problems one should tolerate. Because destiny is there, one should. Agamapaina nitya tanga titikkasra bharat. You should not be disturbed for all these things. This is material world. You will have some time. Matras prasastu sri kasna sukhadukhada. The whole world is like that. There is sometimes distress, there is sometimes happiness. So, to mitigate the worldly distress or getting some happiness, one should not go to guru. That is not the proper way. The proper way is that you should know the problem of life, and Krishna personally says, this is the real problem of your life. What is that? Janma mittu jara vyadhi dukkha dosha anudarshan. This is problem. But they do not know. All rest. Krishna says, na jayate namriyati va kadachit. I am reading Bhagavad Gita. I am a great politician. I am a great leader. I am reading Bhagavad Gita. What do you understand? Do you understand that the soul is immortal and it is transmigrating? Tatha dehantara prapti. Do you know all this problem? Then why you have become national leader? Today I am India and tomorrow I may become a Chinaman. Then where is my nationality? Today I am human being, tomorrow I may be a dog. Then where is my society? Where is my friendship? Where is my love? They do not disclose all these things. Chief guru. But if my soul is transmigrating, tatha dehantara prapti, is it guarantee? Is there any guarantee that today I am Indian and after my death I shall become Indian? No, there is no guarantee. Today I am American and after death I shall become. No, that is not in your hand. After death, your so-called boastfulness, pride, everything finished. There are the classes of, in the Maya's hand, in the nature's hand. Prakitekriyamanani gunai karamani sarvata. Ahankara vinuratma katta ham iti mannade. You are in the hands of the laws of Prakriti, even in this life. Even in this life, if you can eat one chatak, if you eat little more, immediately you become diseased. Immediately. Nature will punish you. 3 days starvation. You have taken more. So this is the law of nature. You cannot violate. There is salt is required, little in the food. If it is little more, you cannot take. If it is little, you cannot take. So stricture, you cannot violate in a slightest degree the laws of nature. But these rascals are thinking that I am independent. Ahankara vinuratma kartaham iti mannate. We should take guidance of the spiritual master, of the guru, or Krishna. Guidance of guru means guidance of Krishna. Because Acharya Manga Vijaniyat Nava Manneta Karhichi. Acharya Manga, Acharya is as good as Guru, as good as Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Guru Krishna Kripaya Paya Bhakti Rata Bhi. Not only Krishna's mercy, but Guru's mercy. Both mercy require. Guru Krishna Kripaya Paya Bhakti Rata Bhi. So, if you are sincere, actually, if you actually want Krishna, then Krishna is within your heart. Ishvara sarva bhutanam nirdesho. When Krishna sees that here is sincere soul, he wants me. Tesang satata yuktanam bhajatam priti bhuvavam buddhi yogam dadamitam. As soon as sees Krishna, that here is a sincere person who wants me, he will give you nice guru, Guru Krishna Kripa. Jasya prasadat bhagavat prasadam. And if you have really a bona fide guru, then by pleasing him, you will get the favor of Krishna. Jasya prasadat bhagavat prasadam. Jasya prasadat nagati kutur. If you have become more than your guru, that overcoming guru, I shall get Krishna's prasad, Krishna's favor. I have learned more. Guru Mara Vidya. That is also not good. Jasya prasadad bhagavat prasad. Jasya, this is the injunction of the Acharya, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. He has described very nicely. The order of Guru should be the life and soul of the disciple, without caring for his personal salvation. This is the qualification of Shishya. Shishyastiham sadhimam prapannam fully surrendered. And Guru's duty is to guide him how to overcome this cycle of birth and death. These are the relationship between guru and disciple, or father and son, mother and son, friend and friend, devata. There are so many devatas in the shastras. There are 33 millions of devata. They say, whatever you worship, the rascal say, not any intelligent man. That whatever devata, you worship Kali, that's all right. You worship Ganesh, that's all right. You worship Surya, that's all right. Whatever you are doing, all right. Is the same thing. No. Krishna does not say. Krishna says, Mamekam. That is what. Krishna never says that you are worshiping Goddess Kali or Durga or this or that. That's all right. But this rascal says, oh, this is all right. And he has become guru. He does not know what is the path of salvation, how one can get rid of this problem of birth, death, and still they preach. There are so many you will find rascal gurus, they are preaching like that. That whatever you do, it is all right. There is a big mission, they say also, jatomat tatopo. Whatever you have manufactured, the way of salvation, that's all right. But Krishna does not say, or the Shastra does not say. Shastra says, harimminanam tinkaranti. Unless you surrender to Krishna, Hari, there is no question of salvation. There is no question of salvation. Therefore, bhunam janonavanti jnanavan mang prabuddhate. One who is bewildered, he thinks that whatever I do, it is all right. That is mistake. That is mistake. The jnanis, they think that they will merge into the existence of the Supreme. That you can merge. That does not mean that you are liberated. Just like you will find one aeroplane is going up and up, 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 and at a time you will find the aeroplane is no more seen at a time. That does not mean he has merged in the sky. He has got a separate existence. But you cannot see. See, even one has got so high, it does not mean that he has merged into the sky. If he does not get another shelter, he'll come back again. He'll come back again. He's not mad. There is no question of mad. Brahma Jyoti means it is the combination of millions and trillions of sparks of living entities. That is Brahma Jyoti. They are not mixed up. Just like the sunshine. The sunshine, it is not one homogeneous substance. There are millions and trillions of shining particles. Combination is called sunshine. It is not that they are merged. Similarly, every individual soul is individual. Krishna says, Arjuna, you, me, and all these soldiers and kings, they were existing before. They are now existing now. And they will continue to exist in the future. So where is mixture? You, me, and all of you, we are different individuals. And Krishna says, not ordinary person, that they were individuals in the past. They are individuals now, and they will continue to become individuals. So where is this question of margin? There is no question of margin. Mama imamsa jiva bhuta jiva loke sanatana. Eternally, they are individuals. And eternally, they will keep individuals. So, this is knowledge. Otherwise, artificially, if I think the same thing, that because I have gone very high in the sky, I have become mixed up with the sky. There is no question of mixing up. Therefore, because it is not the question of mixing up, amalgamation, separate identity, but it is light. That is all right. But not that they have lost their individuality. Sanatana, Krishna says, they are individual parts. Sanatana, eternally. Not that now they are separated and after liberation they will mix up. No. This is wrong concept. Therefore, mixing up means just like we are here, mixed together. We have got individual, but for a certain purpose, we are sitting together very peacefully, and the real purpose is to learn how to serve Krishna. So, when we agree to serve Krishna, then that is mixing up of the devotees. Tadero charana semi sevi bhaktasane bhav. That is mixing up. When you assemble together with the same purpose, that's why we can understand nation. What is that nation? everyone is individual. But the purpose is how to improve the condition of the politics or the combination of men. Similarly, when you agree, here the material world, we are individual, and in the spiritual world, we are also individual. But what is the difference between material world and spiritual world? In the material world, we are individual to serve my own senses. Therefore, there is fight. Everyone is trying to satisfy his own senses. I am trying to satisfy my senses, you are trying. So there is class. That is material world. And spiritual world, when all of them agree to satisfy the senses of Krishna, just like Vrindavan. What is Vrindavan? The devotees of Vrindavan, they are all individuals. The gopis are individual. The cowherd boys are individual. The calves are individual. The cows are individual. Everyone is individual, but the purpose is how to love Krishna. That is one means. There is no disagreement in that purpose. The gopis are trying to satisfy Krishna. The cowherd boys are trying to satisfy Krishna. Mother Yashoda is trying to satisfy Krishna. Nanda Maharaj is trying to satisfy Krishna. The whole center is how to satisfy Krishna. That oneness is required. Not that I become one with Krishna. That is not possible. Therefore, Shastra says, Arujya krichena parama padanga tata patanti adho anadvita jusmatangaya. When they do not agree to serve Krishna, then they come back in this material world. Again they begin to serve the society, to serve the country, to serve the Garita Narayan, to serve this, that. So Arujya Krichena, Param Padam, Tata Patam, Tiyadhasa. Even they go to the Brahma, effulgent, because they do not agree to serve Krishna, Anadita Dusmadangra. They again come back to serve the society, friendship, and Dridhara and so on. So, this is the Bhagavad instruction. One should not become a guru to cheat the disciple, showing him wrong path. That is not good. That is instructive. I resolve that. Thank you very much.